I can't believe we're doing this. This is where you'd hear like footsteps in the night.
Something's gonna pop out of this when I open it.
Did you hear that?
No, genuinely, did you hear that?
No, what? Did I hear what?
No, what's happening?
Why does it sort of look like a coffin? Now that it's after midnight, who wants to have a look what the corridors are like?
No, I was just thinking, what a stupid video idea.
We must be insane.
You're terrified. We've been here 10 minutes. Mm-hmm.
Today I'm here with a video that potentially is the most crazy that I have ever done on this channel. I am literally terrified. If you have not gathered from the title, Tom and I are spending tonight in a haunted 11th century castle in County Durham. And I have actually never been here before. We're sort of near Darlington. I've never heard of this castle before. I did hours and hours of research into places that weren't too far away from us that had ghost stories attached to them that we could also stay in the run-up to Halloween. I thought it was a sick idea. I was like, oh, that is a good video. And now we're here.
You're terrified.
But before we do, Molly from the future is going to show you around the outside of the castle and give you a little bit of history so you can really feel the depth of like the place that we are in, the history that it's seeped in, just how old it is. Tom and I have booked specifically their like suite so that we can get the best feel for it, the biggest room, the most like authentic experience.
We're actually in one of the towers right now. So this, like where the bedroom is like a circular tower.
Are they turrets? No.
I don't know, not clued up. But yeah, it makes it a bit more authentic as well.
Yeah, 100%. I'm trying not to show you too much of the background yet. So we're gonna go and explore the castle and Molly from the future is gonna tell you some of its history. So this is Walworth Castle. It is an 11th century castle near Darlington, County Durham, as I mentioned, and it is actually a Grade 1 listed building. It was originally built for the Hansard family, but it has a long and rich history being passed from owner to owner that actually seem to be continually struck by bad luck and tragedy, and many of them dying in tragic accidents or being struck by the plague. In more recent times, the castle was also a prisoner of war camp during the Second World War, and then even more recently than that, a girls' boarding school. Now the castle is a hotel and has been since 1981, but it stands on the exact same site that it was built and boasts two famous ghost stories, the most famous of which being the so-called Grey Lady, seen by staff and many guests on a number of different occasions floating past room 16 and 17. Now she's believed to have been shut inside the library tower because of rumours she was pregnant with the lord who owned the castle at the time, but as she was only a servant and not his wife, he had her trapped and locked away in the tower where she later died. Today staff and guests alike have reported hearing the sounds of a baby crying from within the walls or a woman climbing the library staircase behind the tower. So it's fair to say that Tom and I, after reading this, felt pretty creeped out and a little bit put off because I don't really deal with the paranormal very well, which you may think is a stupid thing to say given that I literally planned this video myself, but you can be the judge of that yourself. It's time for a room tour. So this is what the outside of the room looks like. Tom's gonna open the door, give you a little intro.
Hansard suite. We should do some research into who.
Yeah, we should.
Maybe his ghost soul lives in here.
This is the room as you walk in. Now, I was pleasantly surprised and also confused because I did not realize that it came with a living room. So I was expecting this room to be a bed. The camera is struggling with the light in here. So we've got these old-fashioned lights, but this is just a living room pretty much as normal. So I'm not gonna dwell on this too much. It's got this absolutely massive desk, like a little bit too much floor space. Like obviously it doesn't really need all of this. Huge, huge window over here. And then these are the like authentic beams of the castle. So this is what makes it look a little bit old. It's got this mirror. Under normal circumstances, I'd be like, oh, this is sick. But currently I'm like, I don't really wanna look in a mirror because what if something jumps out behind me in it that I can't see in real life?
It's gonna happen.
No.
It's gonna be like one of them.
Stop it.
But not the rest of them.
Stop it. Right, we're gonna move on. We then have this corridor, which I also just kind of feel a bit scared by because like corridors, I feel like they're where scary things happen. This is where you'd hear like footsteps in the night. Huge window. The view out here is of like, the courtyard. Bathroom to your left, completely modern, really nice. This is the nicest, least frightening room, and I would consider sleeping in here, to be honest. How are you feeling?
Fine. I actually really like it.
Really? Nice. I'm not feeling fine, I'm feeling nervous.
It's huge.
It's absolutely massive. This is probably the biggest hotel room I've ever stayed in. Right, should we show them the bedroom?
This is where it's at.
This is where the fear is, you mean. Tom and I walked down the corridor. This is what we saw. I just feel like this room has not been updated since like Henry VIII probably stayed here. Pretty much what you see is what you get. We have a four-poster bed. I've never stayed in a four-poster bed before. Not only is it really, really massive, but it's also really high off the ground and like chunky mattress. Under normal circumstances, if it didn't have this like god-awful rim, I would be like, oh my god, that bed looks really comfy. But now I'm just like, I don't really want to get in it. I don't know why it's got such weird bedding. Like, why are there photos of like men on horseback and like people on boats and stuff?
It's so authentic.
You've got the bedside table. I think it's the choice of furniture that's creeping me out. I think this is what's giving me the most stress. So over by the window, this very tall, high floor to ceiling, covered in the same printed curtain, is this little chest, which I don't even really want to open at all. Tom does want to open it.
Something's gonna pop out of this when I open it.
No, stop it.
It's gonna be a ghost. So as soon as we open that, that's gonna unleash the ghost.
This is equally as scary as well. I mean, I think that the fact that my hoodie's on here does undermine it a little bit. But look at this dresser, guys. This looks like something out of like, have you seen The Others?
No.
You've not seen The Others?
What is that?
It's a horror film with Nicole Kidman. Well, it looks like something that would be in The Others, and that gives me the fear. I think it's all just the old-fashioned wood, like the grandeur of it all, but like now it looks really dated. It obviously would have been really grand once upon a time. So I think it's the fact that the room is circular as well. Like, that's really odd. I've never stayed in a circular room. And then, of course, the biggest fear, the wardrobe. What would happen in a horror film, Tom?
You'd open the wardrobe and something would pop out of the wardrobe.
Or you'd be asleep in the night and the wardrobe would just tip up.
Well, maybe the door would open.
Yeah.
Tip up.
Or a hand would just come out from around the side of it, like,
or you get locked in the wardrobe.
Oh yeah, you could get locked in. Do you want to open the wardrobe? Hold on a second, let me set up my camera.
Did you hear that? No, genuinely, did you hear that?
No, what did I hear? What?
A little knocking.
Stop it.
That was the sound it made her to open.
It's just got a little fan inside of it. No, what's happening? Oh, why is it not opening, Tom? What have you done to it? Oh, okay, it's on a latch.
It's on a till.
That's why it's latched shut. Because I imagine other guests have stayed here and in the middle of the night the door will just swing open.
I didn't do that. You saw that.
No, stop it.
Did that actually disturb me?
Yeah, you just didn't close it properly, did you?
Did I latch it?
Yes, please latch it.
I think if I latched it and then we came back in, it was just open.
Nothing would scare me more if that happened in the night. I actually don't know why I thought this video was a good idea. Like, I am somebody that's frightened of everything. And when Harry and I did our stay in Cornwall, I asked you guys what kind of like overnight stay videos you'd want to see. And so many of you were like, stay in a haunted house, stay in an abandoned prison. And at the time I was like, absolutely not. I would never do that. And then it rolled around to Halloween and I was like, oh, that'd be a good idea, as if I just forgot that I'm frightened of everything. So now here we are in this 11th century castle. I think it opened in 1189, because the bar and kitchen is called 1189 Kitchen, and that's the only real reason that I can think of as to why it would be called that. Tom, please don't leave me in this room.
Bye.
Please don't. I could not do this on my own.
Is that window open when we came in?
Stop it.
Genuinely?
Yeah, it must have been.
Didn't notice.
What, so the ghost put the window on the latch, did it?
Yeah, maybe it was a bit hot.
Maybe. Right.
Right, seriously, why is that door open again?
No, it's not really.
We are going to open the medieval chest and
ready?
I am prepared for some kind of exorcist to jump out. What is an exorcist? I'm using that phrase wrong, aren't
the
I?
The exorcist is the original like film from like the 80s.
Right.
Whenever it was out.
Well.
You know, like the girl who's like possessed. She has, like, demons.
So. Let's not talk about horror films right now. What? Is it a spider? What is it? Is it a spider? Stop! That scared me!
That's a scary thing called gravity there.
Why does it sort of look like a coffin?
That'd be what you'll be in later.
In that? What, just my legs?
Chop you up in half.
Well, like a magician.
All your limbs, yeah.
Great. Do you want to do the big central drawer? I feel as though there's probably a Bible in there.
A Bible?
Yeah, I'm getting
That's
Bible
scary
vibes.
If it's a Bible.
Yeah, I know.
That's a hairdryer.
Oh, thank God for that. Oh, and a sewing kit. How niche. Now, I'm definitely getting Bible vibes in one of these drawers.
No, so, you know what that is? That's so the ghost can stab you with a needle.
Right.
And sew your mouth together.
I don't think ghosts are known for, like, sewing your mouth together.
Ooh.
What?
There's something in there.
No, there isn't. You're lying.
Yeah, there is.
What?
That.
What?
That.
I can't believe we're doing this. No Bible. I'm very surprised. Okay, so we have explored the majority of the bedroom. I don't want to try and look in any other hidden crevices, gaps.
Are you already scared enough?
I just think if I'm this frightened and it's daylight, what is it going to be like trying to actually sleep?
Oh, the Bible will be in there.
Oh no.
The Bible's definitely in there. Let's find the Bible.
Guys, comment down below. Would you stay the night here? Would you voluntarily spend your hard-earned cash to put yourself through this? Yes, I did see that.
Ooh.
There's still no Bible. Listen to this, guys.
Guess what?
What?
The Bible!
No way!
Yeah.
No way!
Yeah.
There's a Bible in there.
There's a Bible in there.
Let me see. Just a bit of light reading. Let's make a prayer that we're going to survive.
I'm where it's priest. It's like
you will die tonight.
Yeah. Really? What's scaring me more, guys? Listen to this. We are going to have some dinner and then I will catch up with you. We're unsure if we're going to actually eat here because even though we're here on a horror night away, there's actually a wedding going on downstairs and the whole venue was kind of like taken up by that. When we got here, they actually asked if we were part of the wedding party and we were like, no, we're just here to film a video and hopefully see some ghosts. So I'm hoping any crazy noise we hear in the night is just the wedding party. That's it. It is a nice venue for a wedding if you're not scared of stuff like this and if you didn't choose to maybe come in October.
You'd be too battered at a wedding to even notice.
Well, we could always just go join in and like... Right, we'll catch up with you. I'll maybe film a little bit of dinner. I think because of the venue downstairs and stuff, we may go into Darlington for food. But maybe we could have breakfast here in the morning.
Yeah, sure.
If we're still alive. Tom's got a parma. Is that what it's called? Parma? Yeah, it's basically the delicacy of the northeast. Darlington specifically, I think, though, actually. Darlington and Middlesbrough. I'm gonna get a load of people from Durham commenting that it's also a Durham thing, but I think it's Darlington and Middlesbrough. But yeah, obviously I cannot have it because essentially it's just a lump of chicken with cheese on the top. So after a considerably less scary meal in Darlington, we headed back to Walworth Castle and saw it in the dark for the first time. And I imagine if it wasn't lit with these funky neon lights, it would probably be a lot more eerie. But even so, I didn't really like being stood outside. It felt like we were really cut off from society. We have returned to the castle after our dinner in Darlington. It is now pitch black. The castle is all lit from underneath and we are going to head back to our room. There it is behind. Our room is going to be dark. We are stood currently by a lantern that is absolutely covered in spiderwebs. Shall we head in?
Yes, let's go.
Even the windows up here creeping me out. Oh, that could be our room actually, Tom.
I was thinking that, but I think we're a floor higher than that.
Yeah, we are a floor higher than that. I think that there, that light coming out of that window there is our room. Actually, if you take away the scary element of it, it is really beautiful. In we go, guys. We are returning.
You did actually scare me.
Guys, we have just got back to the rooms. Let me show you what Tom's doing. Tell me that's not creepy as. I don't actually like that we have a living room. It's like there's so much extra space where people could be hiding. Hi, that's me in the mirror. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. What on earth are you doing? We have made it back to the hotel. I might brave having a shower, although when I got here earlier, come in here, I don't like that you're loitering, it's scaring me. I was so scared to go to the toilet alone that I made Tom stand in the toilet with me while I went for a wee because I just didn't want there to be like, even though this toilet's super modern.
You're okay, come here.
So far so good in terms of the room. However, I think it'll be when we actually come to like go to bed that the fear hits.
And the sounds will start.
That's what I mean, because I'm such a light sleeper. I wake up at everything and I also fall asleep. It takes me ages to fall asleep.
Whoa. That's what the buzzing is. It's the extractor fan.
Okay, can you turn the light back on please? You should play a game called take a shot every time I go, stop it. Scare me.
Oh.
Do your best scary face.
Just imagine that like, if you saw like a figure in the corner of the room, it would probably be doing something like...
What, his neck's broken, is it?
I was also thinking like that. If you saw that...
Just right, the silhouette.
Just imagine that like, you get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. Uh-huh. Right? If you saw that, I'd be like, there's a person just hung up in the corner of the room. Just looks a bit like if I'm going to see a ghost tonight, it's going to be in that corner.
I think if we're going to see a ghost tonight, it's going to be coming out of our 15th century medieval wardrobe.
Nice, this room.
This is the best room. Shall we sleep
There's no ghosts in here.
Shall we sleep in the shower?
Okay.
I actually don't mind this too much, guys, now that I've had four Proseccos. I think the best way to deal with fear is Prosecco. Wow, that's dreadful advice. Oh my god, a poltergeist pulled down Tom's trousers.
Brilliant. A halter neck.
What? A halter neck? Do you know what a poltergeist is?
Should I?
What is it?
A poltergeist. It's like a ghost that moves the furniture. Geist. It's like the kind of spirit that would like throw the furniture around. So you know when you hear reports of like, oh my god, I woke up in the middle of the night and my chest of drawers was being thrown around the room. A ghost is just like a spirit that would haunt you in the night. Guys, no. I was running the hot tap because I really, really needed to take my makeup
just
off.
Just had the first paranormal activity.
Oh my god.
Literally, it took like a good 3 or 4 minutes for the tap to heat up and then all this brown
that gunk,
as you can see,
this colour
just came out the tap. It's all right now.
No, stop it. I've watched the Cecil Hotel.
Maybe there was just a blockage.
Has that ever happened to you in your house?
Paranormal.
I want to boil the kettle.
It's fine now.
Cecil Hotel. I'm too scared.
It's now and again going this colour.
Does any plumber want to comment what's happening in the comments, please?
There.
There's a body in the water tank.
Paranormal.
Tom's getting a money spider that just dangled out of the air.
I don't actually know where it is, to be honest. I missed it.
Tom has decided that now that it's after midnight, he wants to have a look what the corridors are like, because all of the sightings of ghosts and apparitions happen in the corridors after midnight. I really think you're going to be disappointed, because I think the lights will just stay on. Have you got the key?
Yeah, I don't need it.
What if it slams closed behind us? Do the lights stay on? The pipes, you can hear the pipes.
It's a bit spooky, yeah.
Even like that we left the door like this.
Let the spirits in.
Nah, this floorboard. Okay, it is now. Did we just say quarter to one in the
morning?
Yeah,
quarter to one now.
We're gonna just admit defeat and go to sleep. I have tried to avoid it because I'm frightened of getting in the bed more than anything. Like, look at this bed that we're about to get into. I don't want to pull the curtain across for two reasons. One,
spiders will drop out of it.
Yeah. But then also, do I want them above me? Also, I don't know if it's more scary to sleep with the curtains open or to close the curtain. I think leave the curtains just as they are. Every time Tom leaves the room, guys, I have to go with him because I don't want to be on my own. Oh God, I just don't like it at all, guys. No offense if you've got one of these beds that are like four-poster beds, but what on earth are you doing? Am I Henry VIII? Tom's going to turn the hanging lamp on so
I
that-
I can't do anything in a pen here because it's quite actually scary. I wouldn't usually be scared because he's constantly-
I know, running. I know. Guys, I'm gonna sleep in my socks in case I have to make a quick run for it in the middle of the night. Tom's got the cushions off the bed. I actually think the bed looks sort of comfortable. Stop it! Do you not want to check under the bed before you get in it?
I don't know.
Anything under there?
No, you can't
fit. Really, is that all?
Yeah.
Would you be lying to me? What if there's a bug?
There was nothing. I even looked for spiders.
Alright, guys. It is now 1 a.m. We are in bed. And I will update you in the night if I wake up. As I say, we haven't closed any curtains. We are sleeping with the light on because this room is just giving me a vibe, and it isn't a good vibe, it's a bad vibe. How are you feeling about this?
I'm just gonna have a read of the reported sightings.
No, don't read the ghost stories now, we'll read them after.
No, I'm just gonna read them to myself.
Why would you want to do that?
Because I might, you know, what to look out for.
If I don't speak to you in the night, which hopefully I won't, I'll pick you up in the morning. Please pray for us and wish us luck. More than anything that's annoying, there's a tiny little fly buzzing around and it's like
what's it like?
Yeah, we're sleeping with the lights on, so good night. We survived this self-inflicted ordeal. Right, I was just thinking, what a stupid video idea. Why did I think to do this? I was terrified. And subsequently, I didn't sleep really at all. I think because we slept with the lights on, I struggled to sleep anyway because I usually have to sleep in like the pitch black. 5:30 rolled around, I was just still awake. Tom was just asleep next to me. I was just like, is that a ghost? What was that sound? What was that noise? What was that noise? Is that noise coming from the outside? Turns out it's now 8:30 in the morning and we are gonna try and have the breakfast here in the castle. First, I'm gonna hop in the shower. Oh, I look and feel exhausted. All right, so I need to be the first one down the corridor myself, which is fine because it's daylight now. It looks quite sunny.
You got this.
This looks considerably less frightening in the daylight. We are gonna go downstairs to the castle kitchen in attempt to get breakfast. Oh my. Tom's bartering with me for my hash brown because it doesn't have hash brown and you didn't order one. If you could have probably asked for one. Anyway, my breakfast looks nice. I'll give you half, how's that? That's a deal. I mean, the fact that it has a dungeon inside it is a little bit frightening. Oh my God, we should have found this last night. That's scary. The fact that the breakfast hall is just next to the dungeon does make me feel sort of uneasy. We are about to leave this room. We're gonna explore the grounds a little bit before we leave because we haven't been outside in the daylight, but this is goodbye from the four-poster bed. I hope I never see you again.
It was lovely. Also, we can do a tour of the dungeon. but Molly's too scared.
You have to get special access from the staff here at the hotel, and also the reviews online say that it's just filled with spiders. I'm sure you can imagine what a dungeon looks like.
After quite a night, we packed up our things and prayed that we hadn't offended any spirits or ghosts that might want to follow us home, and loaded up the car, and we were pretty much ready to go. We made a little stop off in the North Yorkshire town of Richmond, where neither Tom or I had been since we were children, and then we pretty much headed straight back. I was ready to be somewhere that felt less haunted.
Bit dishevelled.
Yep.
From the lack of sleep because of the ghosts, isn't it?
Because of all the ghosts.
Because of all the ghosts. We are back home, guys. This was something, really it was. Thank you for coming with me.
That's okay, it was really good. It was really good.
Sometimes I just say to Tom, oh, by the way, shall we go stay in a haunted castle for the weekend? Or, oh, by the way, shall we just go to Blackpool to sleep in a helicopter for the weekend? And Tom's just like, yeah.
I'm just like, yeah, cool.
You're used to it by this point.
I like doing it. It's something different. It's something I would never normally have done, so like, why not?
Yeah, I'm not sure I'm ever going to do it again.
What, the haunted one?
Anything like that, because to be honest, it wasn't that it was like haunted. I mean, it did feel creepy, but like the whole vibe just like made me feel a bit like,
what is that face?
Like things that go bump in the night, noises you can't explain. I think a big off put was the 4-poster bed. If we hadn't have had that bed, I really think I would have felt more comfortable.
To be fair, the only thing that was a bit old was the bedroom.
Yeah.
The bathroom was definitely newly renovated.
100%, yeah, yeah.
That was really nice. And
it was really nice, but the water running brown wasn't
a bit creepy, but maybe that's their vibe. Maybe that's what they're going for with the bedrooms.
Yeah, I think it is,
because they wouldn't have just stopped at the living room and the bathroom. Like,
yeah,
maybe they want to keep the room, especially with it being in the tower.
Yeah,
maybe they just want to keep that a bit more authentic.
Yeah, I think that's definitely the vibe they're going for. And when we read the reviews, it's a real mixed bag between we really love it and it needs renovating, and that was what the bedroom was like.
They could keep that bed and like the furniture, but just change the bedding, getting the curtains, that kind of thing.
It was just a very odd vibe. It made me feel a bit like something is going to jump out. The wardrobe, the dresser, the chest of drawers, everything made me feel a bit like
the Bible.
I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. It's a little bit different for Halloween. Thank you for being a good sport and for joining me.
That's okay. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I'm sure you'll see Tom in another video very soon. You definitely will, because we're going to Hull Fair this week. Subscribe to see more. Don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up if you did enjoy it. And I want to know in the comments, would you have stayed the night here? Would you do it again?
I wouldn't do that place again, because we've done it. Happily do like another haunted house again, or haunted whatever again.
You might be on your own. Bye, guys.